Hello and welcome to what we have titled as Jugalbandi, the question challenge. With me today are two of the young and well-known quiz masters of India. I don't think either of them needs an introduction, but for the sake of it, I'll just share their names with you. As you can see on screen, we have Vishnu and we have Naman. Vishnu, of course, has been active for the last year or so with TACON, which has really revolutionized the way cuisine is accessible across the country, the length and breadth of it. And now he seems to be drawing attention from overseas as well. So before starting with what Jugalbandi is, I have always been quite intrigued with what goes behind into coming up with these new offerings. For example, Vishnu came up with a multi-language simultaneous quiz, Atulya Bharat 2.0, which received a huge response. And of course, Naman's India quizzes and Eureka and the other quizzes under quiz of the Phoenix brand, they have been doing really well. So Vishnu, what is it that you keep doing that you know every now and then you come up with something new and it's always a hit? We'd like to know that.
Okay, I don't know what prompts me to get into new idea always, but this particular idea I can explain. So I was talking almost an year and a half ago or something. I used to play something called Jugalbandi with one of my friends. I used to send 5 questions to the person, and the person used to send me five questions back to me. So it was like a challenge, who can answer more. So that's where the name Jugalbandi came from. And the concept which we are going to do today started with another person, which we were doing a normal conversation, and there was some challenge. Then we said, okay, we'll give one word to each other. We should make a question on that word. Like, that word should come in the answer. But even though you know the answer, you can't get the answer. That was the challenge. So that's where I combined both of them and calling it Jugalbandi, and I wanted to try something new. So I asked you and Naman, both of you agreed, we're doing it.
It's a great name to have, definitely. Jugalbandi, as we all know, is, you know, people playing in unison, normally used in music, and of course very aptly used in quizzing sense here by Vishnu. And one fine day I get a message from Vishnu saying that, hey, I am giving you 10 random words, you need to select 3 out of them and send them across to Naman. And within 5 minutes I get the same message from Naman. The biggest challenge here is the fact that those words, you know, in a normal quizzing scenario, you would think that those would be the question words. But here we are talking about words, those specific words being in the answer. So out of the 10 random words that were given to me by both Naman and Vishnu, I selected at random 3. So Vishnu knows the 3 that are supposed to, you know, form a part of a question, the answer to which has to be the 3 words.
One of the
Naman words. Doesn't know what the question is. Manas doesn't know what that question is, and the vice versa happens in case of Naman's words. So, who would like to take the first step?
I'll go with it. My screen is already there. So, basically, I'll again explain. Naman gave 10 words to Manas. Manas gave 3 words from those 10 words to me, and I chose 1 word and made a question on it. Now, no one, like Naman doesn't know, Manas doesn't know which word I chose, and even audience doesn't know which word I chose. I'll show you the question first. It first goes to Naman and then it goes to Manas, or both of you can try it together, and audience can also comment it in the comment section now. And after the answer is revealed, I'll show you a small clipping of on how the question making process went on. And so the first question is, look at a picture. It's a place somewhere in Paris. So lime sulfate was once considered as the best source of sulfur and was used as a fertilizer, also leading to a war when its smugglers were restricted to import into Canada. So an island in Canada, not exactly the mainland Canada, but an island of Canada. So it was known as Montmartrite. So just read it. I might be pronouncing it wrongly. So after its major source in Paris, near Paris. A part of its common name is also a generic name of Johnson & Johnson's flagship product in British English. What am I talking about? So you understand the question, right? The picture here is the picture of a location near suburb of Paris called Montmartre. So something was found here anciently, like in the ancient world, something was abundantly found here. So that element was called Mount Matratite. And then that was also used as a, what you call, fertilizer. And that also led to some war in Canada, which is named after this thing. And it is also a common name, common generic name of Johnson & Johnson's flagship product in British English. So what am I talking about? Naman, it's your chance. You can guess. So the answer
I have no idea, but I don't know about Johnson & Johnson's flagship product, but Paris lime sulfate, I'll guess plaster of Paris.
Yeah, and Manas, what's your guess?
I was also thinking along the similar lines. I was also thinking of either cement or plaster of Paris.
Yeah, this is of course plaster of Paris, and generic name of Band-Aid is plaster in British English. They simply call it plaster. So the word given to me here by Naman is plaster. So plaster of Paris is where his word came in, and plaster in British English is the generic name for Band-Aid.
So yeah, this is Paris. Paris was enough. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, Paris. Or I wouldn't have got it. Lime sulfate.
Yeah, this is anyway you one of your 10 words. You should have guessed. You could have guessed one of your 10 words.
I didn't remember my 10 words now.
I don't remember any of the words that I have sent to you. It's actually fun, because I frankly didn't remember.
Okay.
Even I didn't.
Now I'll show the video, the process how I made this question. This is just a 52 second video. We'll just upload the different video with the length of 13 minutes after this video on the same channel. You can go through it. Now it's only a fast forwarded 52 second video. You can't read anything there. You can just see with some music. Yeah.
Fascinating, all the effort that goes into creating questions which perhaps seem to others to be a cakewalk to frame. But let me assure you, having quizzed with both Vishnu and Naman for the last maybe 7-8 months now, that each and every single one of their questions is extensively researched, verified by multiple sources, because as we all know, Wikipedia is a source that's not entirely reliable always. Although that was a part of the video. So I think you should appreciate the effort that goes behind, setting seemingly either easy or difficult questions.
Yeah. It depends. Wikipedia as a source depends on the topic you're working on. If you're working on some conspiracy, political secrets or not secrets, like some controversial things, Wikipedia can't be a source. But some scientific facts, which are facts, established facts, Wikipedia, like, there's nothing wrong with Wikipedia.
Yeah.
Okay, so Naman, now it's,
yes, Naman, time for revenge.
Revenge?
So the same thing happened here. I gave 10 words to Manas, Manas gave 3 words to Naman, Naman chose one word, and we don't know which word he chose, and we're going to try it now.
Yeah, Hook Norton Brewery is a regional brewery in Oxfordshire, England, which is shown in the image, which follows a distinct type of architecture and is classified as Victorian X Brewery. So these were the Victorian breweries in the 18th century. And the highest point in such kinds of breweries would be a water X, and the next highest point, a prominently ventilated attic. The image is very helpful. And for hints on X, they have been used since prehistoric times, their main purpose being surveillance of surrounding areas. In spite of not being defined as X, modern high-rise buildings use it in their name. Just a small error. It's buildings, not building. So if you even look out of your house or in your area, many buildings must be having X as their name after a proper noun or a common noun. So identify X. Image is very helpful. First, we'll go to Vishnu.
Okay, I forgot the words which I gave. I remember few, but
even I did.
The image will be very helpful, and the Hook Norton Brewery has a water X and a prominently ventilated attic. And just look at the image. So the yellow italic and bold part serve as hint. Main purpose being surveillance of surrounding areas and modern high-rise building. Use it in their name.
Okay. So okay, tower.
Yeah. Tower. Manas.
Yeah, I'll also go with that name, the tavern, TAVN.
I say tower.
T-A-V-E? Oh, you said tower. Yes. Okay. I was yes, sir. With the brewery, I actually started thinking of tavern. So tower seems to be a better guess. Yes. Definitely.
Yeah, yeah. The answer is tower. You can see the two prominent towers here. Beside the building and the white one, the smaller white one. So these are the tower breweries of, these are called as Victorian tower breweries. And this one is present in Oxfordshire, England.
Yeah, nice. Actually, I gave you, like, nice. I was sitting in the same place when I sent you the 10 words. And I was looking outside. So two things I saw there was a slab was going on. Slab was one of the words which I gave you, and that there's a tower there. So the tower was the other word. So again, I saw there. it's
quite interesting, the way you framed it now. And if it also has to do with the fact that many breweries these days serve towers of beer.
So I have the whole video of 20 minutes of gaming. My first thought was tower beer towers, the Kingfisher beer towers, which my friends usually take in pubs. I am a teetotaler, but they use the Kingfisher Towers. So I started searching on it, and there was a suggestion of tower breweries. So this was something new for me, and then I started researching on that and came up with this question.
But Naman will show the 1 minute making video of his question, and later after this video, you can see the full video of whatever 20 or 25 minutes work he has done. That will be uploaded as a different video on the same channel.
And so we come to the end of this wonderful short and sweet Jugalbandi. This was only episode 1 of what is promising to be a long series in the making. But before we go, of course, the moderator, you know, he plays his own silly jokes on the quiz masters every now and then. And so I have taken the liberty of giving one common word to both Vishnu and Naman. They will come up with a question the way they did in the start at the start of this episode on the same word, which is Google. And the audience, meanwhile, has the time to frame their own versions of questions, the answers to which should contain the word Google. Let's see how creative we all can be. We have an example in front of us in the form of Vishnu and Naman. That's it, folks. Thank you, Vishnu. Thank you, Naman.
See you in the next episode.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Manas.
See you in the next episode. And Naman is doing a quiz tomorrow. Naman, can you pitch about your quiz?
Yeah, guys, so I'll be doing the second edition of my general quiz, Eureka 2.0, at 4 p.m. tomorrow, that is Sunday, 8th November. So do join in. Vishnu,
we'll post the link in the description. You can join that.
Okay, sure.
Yeah, and thank you. See you soon within few hours on the second episode.